Hello Shopify store owner, welcome back to another video. Welcome back to another Shopify tutorial video. In this video, I'll teach you guys how you can create a stylish and awesome looking FAQ page on your Shopify store for free. So you don't have to install any app. First of all, you don't have to pay any app. You don't have to subscribe to any app. You just have to follow this video and subscribe to this channel if you want to learn more free things. And watch me how I am doing this to add a stylish looking FAQ page, which will look something like this. So that's my development store. And I'm going to navigate to the mega menu, which I created on another tutorial. If you want to learn how to create a mega menu like this, like animated images and all of the stuff like that, there's another tutorial. Link will be in the description. But in today's video, I'm teaching you guys how you can create an FAQ page. So that's my FAQ page. And I'm gonna go to that FAQ page and see how it looks. So that's how my FAQ page looks like. So all of this is dummy content which I have added. And good thing about this is that it's not built using code. I mean, it is built using code, but you don't have to code in order to create an FAQ section like this. All you have to do is just add a section, which I'm going to tell you how you can add and customize it using the theme customizer in Shopify. You don't have to play with the CSS, liquid code, anything like that. All you have to do is just play with the customizer to make it look more cooler. So that's the customized setting of this cool FAQ page. So as you can see, we have a lot of options here, and we can adjust the layout gap. So here's the layout gap, which you saw that it's being adjusted. I'm gonna get it back to what it was before. And you can change the image here to whatever you want to. And let me show you if I change to it to another image. Okay, so our image has changed, but I wanted an FAQ image. So I'm going back to my old FAQ image. Cool. Here we have image border thickness. So image has a border around it, and we can adjust the border of it. And we can change the aspect ratio of image. So if you want it to be original resolution, you can select the original. If you want the landscape version, you can simply change it from the drop down. We have square and portrait as well. I'm going to switch it back to original, and you can select a different aspect ratio for the mobile version. So if I switch to the mobile version, I can change it the way how it looks. So you can see that's how it looks in the mobile version for now. Let's switch it to square to see how it looks. So now you can see the mobile version is showing the square version, which is a bit better than the portrait, or if I switch to original, because in the mobile, it's really important to make it look mobile friendly, right? Okay, and here we have image position for the desktop, and here we have image position for the mobile version. So let's switch back to the desktop. And if you want your image to show second, like you want this part, which is the text part, want to display first, and this image to be displayed second, you can switch it here. And these settings are here for the mobile version. Cool, we can change the headings. And we can also use custom font for this heading specifically. So if you will add the section, it will automatically detect the font, but you have the option to choose a separate font other than your theme. So by default, it's like this. So you can see it's pulling up the font styling from my theme settings, the other fonts which I have added, but you can add the custom font optionally if you want to. And we have these fonts showing up here, which are in the Shopify system. So you can choose any of the font, right? And here we have the heading size options. And here we have the heading size for mobile. So all of the settings here is very mobile friendly. You can customize it on mobile separately, which is very important because more than 80% of the visitors will be coming through the mobile devices, not the actual desktop. So it's really important to have all of the mobile settings. That's why my team have a separate settings for the mobile for every single block in this section. Okay, let's scroll down, and here we have header text alignment. So you can text it, align it left and right. And here we have the separate alignment for the mobile version. And again, the padding for the vertical heading. So that's the padding which we have above heading. You can adjust it by here. Okay. Similarly, we have horizontal heading and the separate horizontal heading for the mobile version. FAQ item settings. So here we have FAQ items, which we can increase. So if I go back here, we have these blocks showing up here. We'll just keep on increasing the FAQ items. Right, and it's also automatically adding these numbers. I'm gonna show you these number setting as well, so you can change the size of these numbers, and you can also remove it if you want, but it's stylish, and if you want to keep it, I would suggest to keep it. Okay, let's go back to the settings where we were. Okay, padding vertical. So if you want to again adjust the vertical padding, separate padding for the mobile version. Here we have the border top thickness. So a ton of settings you will find here, and that's the number settings. So you're seeing this number, you can adjust the number size here. Now you can see it's a little bigger, and you can have a separate size for the mobile version, right? And here's the line height. And if you want to hide this number, you don't want to display this number at all, you can simply check this mark and it will be hidden. Again, we have this custom font settings. If you want to add a custom font for questions, you can simply check this mark and you can see that it's now showing on the custom font. Here we have again lot of sizing options, lot of padding options for answers, for questions, and all of the settings. And now we have these color settings here, right? We can change the image border color. So from black, if I want to switch it to red, and we had this image border on top here, where it is. So here it is, the image border thickness. Now you can see it's showing the red border, right? Let's go back to the color settings. Here we have the item border color. So we switched it to red. Number color, question color, answer color, and here we have the heading colors, section colors, margin settings. I mean, a lot of settings you will find, and one of the top coolest thing which we added is the lazy load feature. So if you have a very heavy image, it's gonna have the lazy load feature. So if you have this section added on home page and there is an image, it's only loaded when you actually scroll over that to that section and to that image. So this section can be added to any page. I created a separate FAQ page to show you guys, but you can add that section to any of the page. Okay, now let me show you how you can actually add this section and the page to your store. So in my development store, okay, so in my development store, I have this already added here in the menu with the mega menu. And by the way, I have created some other cool sections as well. If you are visiting this channel for the first time, we have this video section which is on autoplay, and here we have the option to add heading. We have the option to add these buttons, and all of this without needing you to code. All of these are ready-made sections, and all you have to do is just follow the videos which I have on my channel. And if you also want to add the customized contact form, you can do that as well. Okay, let's go to adding the FAQ section and FAQ page. So what I'm gonna do, I'll install the Fresh Dawn theme and show you guys how it's gonna work. So we will scroll down to our themes and to the theme section, and then click on Dawn and click on this add button. Okay, our Dawn 15.0.2, which is the latest version, is being stored. And guys, while this is being stored, make sure to click on the link if you are signing up for the Shopify for the first time. There's the promotion going on where you'll get free 3-day trial, and only $1 per month you will be charged for creating a Shopify store, not the normal pricing. So if you want to sign up and avail this offer, make sure to click on the link below. Okay, our Dawn 15.0.2 has been installed, and I'm going to hit publish and show you guys how we can create an FAQ page like this with a fresh Dawn theme. By the way, it's not just implemented on Dawn theme. You can install that on any of the free theme. So if you have a Spotlight, Refresh, Sense theme, Craft theme, on any of the free theme, even you can use this section on the paid theme because it is created using the section Liquid Code. So you don't have to worry about any of the theme settings or something like that. It's working independently. Okay. We have our Dawn 15.0.0 install, and let's go back to our store and hit refresh to see how it looks. Okay, we'll have to click preview. So click on this three small dots and then click preview. And I'm going to close the old tab here. Okay, here we have our fresh Dawn theme. So that's how the default Dawn theme looks like. And if I go to pages and if I click on FAQ, you can see that we don't have anything showing up here because we'll have to add the section. Okay, now let's add the section, and I'm going to go back to the theme settings and then click on these three small dots and then click on edit code to go to the code editor. And here we will scroll down, and under sections, we'll click on add a new section, and I'm going to name it custom FAQ section. You can name it whatever you want. Because it doesn't really matter. You can name the Liquid file to whatever you want to name it. Okay, click on done. And here we have the code available. So that's the code which we will use. And we created a section already. And all you have to do is just click on this copy code button and paste it here. First, remove the code which is already in the file when you create it. I'm going to remove all of the code which already came with custom FAQ section, and after removing all of the code, paste the code which we have copied from here. Link of this code will be in the video description, so you don't have to worry about it. Click on save, and perfect, we have our section created. Now what we're gonna do, we'll click on exit here and then click on customize. And now we will create a new template for our FAQ page. So click on this drop down here, go to pages here, and then click on create template. And we will name our page template FAQ, and then click on create template. Perfect. After creating the template, you can see that it automatically assigned to one of the FAQ page which I had in the backend. If you're not seeing this assigned to one page, what you will need to do is, first let's go to, so I'm going to open the dashboard of Shopify on the new tab and show you guys where you will need to assign that template. So I'm assuming you already have created the page. So if you click on online store and then click on pages, so I have all of these pages. So you will just click on add page and create a new page. And once that page is created, like I have this FAQ page, you'll have to select this template here. It automatically selected in my case because I have the same name of the page and the name template. So it automatically assigned it. Okay, let's now add our section which we created. So let's click on add section, and I'm going to search for FAQ. And here we have custom FAQ section, and our section is added. Now again, you can change the image and you can do all of the setting which I showed you guys in the video previously. Perfect. Now let's visit the store. I'm going to go to pages and then click on FAQ. And here we have our FAQ section ready, where you don't have to code anything. All you have to do is just add the section code, and your section will be added to any of the page. I added this in FAQ page, but you can also add it on homepage. So if we go back and go to homepage from this drop down here, so that's our homepage. And if we click on add section here and search for FAQ, click on custom FAQ section, you can see that we have an FAQ section showing up on homepage right now. Cool, right? So that's it for the video, guys. If you want to learn more, make sure to subscribe to the channel, comment on the video below. Until next video, have a great day.